So I'm here with Matt, and he's obviously a Sanders supporter. Matt, why don't you tell us what brings you out here today?
I'm out here because I have the chance to do this. I have the choice and the option to come out here and promote Bernie, to try to appeal to all of these people that are just on the Trump train of tragedy. It's like they got those little Magner sheep blinders on, and they're going to follow this train wreck, this logic of, you know, capitalism to the very bitter end. You know, Trump's got no answers to anything. He hasn't fixed immigration. He hasn't fixed the environment. He's not, you know, approaching gun laws, but anything. He's burying everything. He's starting more fires left and right, but he's not really trying to fix anything. So Bernie has solutions. You know, Medicare for all is a great thing. You know, working on the environment to, you know, limit emissions globally. You know, bringing back the rules that worked before in California.
What are you kind of getting on the ground as far as like support for Bernie and stuff? Because you see,
so I do a lot of canvassing for Bernie. I've worked with him for a couple years now.
Yeah.
And it's pretty much Biden or Bernie here in New Hampshire. There's more people choosing Bernie than door to door.
There's 40 a lot of people. Pete stuff, right?
I heard about, yeah, Pete. He was big in there.
Iowa. He had a big search.
He has a big ground game.
Yeah, huge one in Iowa. They're still waiting for the results for that. You know, they said he wants 26% or 26 delegates. 14 and Bernie won 12. I don't know those numbers, man. I don't know. It's like, all I know is democracy. Bernie got screwed in 2016. It's looking like that's going to happen again.
Yeah.
Hillary's still in the background. Debbie Wasserman Schultz is still working in the DNC.
We keep hearing these things again. They're rumors
it's a true story. Can you imagine being Bernie Sanders and seeing the girl that stabbed you in the back still working there? That blows my mind, man.
She
committed major fraud. It's huge. And it's a garden party. So you just read my Facebook page, man. You can see I'm not allowed on Facebook right now. I've got like 3 more days till I'm off.
Yeah.
I'm forever kicked off Twitter. But
so what do you think is actually going to happen? We're going to get like the New Hampshire results before we actually get Iowa and stuff?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, this is real easy. New Hampshire keeps it simple. You know.
And March 10th is the big one, Super Tuesday. And California's in it this time.
So you're thinking Bernie's going to take New Hampshire?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Is that where you've been getting as a vibe on the ground?
Pretty much everyone I talk to on the phone is probably like, there you go, right here. This is fucking, what's his name? Mitt Romney talking about his religion, right? And why he voted the way he did.
Right.
This is what I put on Facebook, man. He misses the garden party. That Mueller's part of, Bush's part of, Hillary's part of, all these motherfuckers are the garden party. And I can talk about it, no one believes me. So I finally got proof back on 2-7 at 5:25 a.m.
So what specifically the garden party? That's a newer term for myself.
There's a whole political system called the garden party from Russia. They wrote this book, some lady back in like the 1820s wrote about the garden party, which is all about oligarchs. And so when that motherfucker said that, I was like, I knew it.
So you think it's just kind of like a power elite? If you're not in the club, yeah, you're excluded.
Obviously, man. It's been that way for a long time. It's just getting worse and more obvious. Trump is just like, he's a habitual line stepper. He's like, fuck the line. I'm gonna do whatever I want. I'm gonna grab a girl by the pussy. She's gonna go to the cops. Say I grabbed her by the pussy. And I'm not gonna get in trouble. Okay. Right now, if I grab that girl by the pussy, and, you know, she says I did it, you know, that'd be one thing. If she just turns around and tells that cop I grabbed her by the pussy, they're gonna say, why'd you assault her? I'm like, well, hopefully there's cameras everywhere.
There tends to be almost a two-tier criminal justice system. If you have money,
exactly,
you tend to be able to get away with a lot more things.
Like Bloomberg buys his way under the ballot.
No. As far as I know, it was legal. He made the 3 separate donations, but it's highlighting a problem within the system.
It's ridiculous. The system is fucked. Trump is the perfect catalyst to show that the system is fucked. When it came down to Hillary or Trump on the ballot, I was like, that's when it became political.
Well, that's
in October. I woke up and I was living down in Fort Lauderdale when he won.
Friends out there, yeah.
I love Fort Lauderdale, man. I used to live out in Phoenix, Arizona.
Yeah.
A lot of these people, one of my buddies at work, I just saw him with a huge Trump thing hanging off his head, man.
Yeah.
That big Trump cape. And I was just like, you know why he likes Trump?
What's that?
Per his words, verbatim, because no one else likes him.
Well, do you think a lot of the coverage of the president has been negative? Like, when you start going after, like, 2 scoops of ice cream, something, there are plenty of things to go after the president for, but when you start kind of going the ad hom thing, it's like you're kind of making a sympathetic figure.
I got no sympathy for him, man. All he does is bully. He talks shit. Like, he challenged Hillary to a debate, and that was crazy. Now you got everyone challenged him to a debate, and he's ducking and running, man. The world's most quiet and stable genius when he's supposed to be, you know.
Oh, yeah, I'm the smartest guy in the world.
Very stable genius.
Yeah, exactly. I believe that was the guy that told that. That was his original position. he has some guys go in there and raid his office.
Yeah.
And take his medical files.
So let me ask you this. What do you think the outcome's going to be for tomorrow? What are we going to see?
I think Bernie's going to win like probably 40% of the vote, maybe. Yeah. I don't know.
Okay.
Maybe Bernie, and then, I don't know, Biden's falling apart. He's imploding by the second. Every 5 minutes, he just gets worse and worse.
I hear
that. He's surging, man.
Yeah.
Tulsi's, New Hampshire used to like Tulsi. I think people are going from Tulsi to Pete.
I like Tulsi. I saw her.
Both military guys. Yeah, Tulsi's cool.
It's there. We went to an Andrew Yang event, talked with some Mayor Pete supporters there, so we'll see what happens. But, hey, I thank you. Thank you for your
time, brother. Matt, thank you for your time, man.
Take care. Stay warm, man. See you.
Have a good one, guys.